Hello dear students, in the previous class we have learned that how the circle by using different methods is drawn in AutoCAD. Now today we are going to discuss the method to draw arc in AutoCAD. So we will draw arc by using different methods. So first of all we have to go to ribbon, draw area of ribbon. This is ribbon and this is the draw area of ribbon in which the draw commands are present. And the first draw command is the arc. We have already discussed the line command, polyline command and circle. Now it is arc. So for arc, we have to click on this arrow. So first option for drawing arc is 3-point method. For 3-point method. So to specify 3-point, let's draw a line. Okay. Select line and draw line and again skin. So we will draw the line in this manner. Now we have to draw an arc using 3-point method. So click on this arrow, you will get the option 3-point. Click on this, select any 3-point on this line. This is the first point, this is the second point and this is the third point. So this is how the arc is drawn by using 3-point method. This is the first point, this is the second point and this is the first point. You can come to know about the point which you have selected by clicking on this arc. So this is the first point, this is the second point and this is the third point. Okay. So this is how the arc is drawn by using 3-point method. Now, if you want to give the dimension to this arc, so what you have to do, you have to click on this annotate, then click on this arrow and you will get the option arc length. You have to give the radius or diameter to the arc. If you have to give the arc length, you have to click on this arc length and select this arc, you will get this arc length. Now if you want to give the radius of the arc, then click on this button and you will select either radius or diameter. So you will select radius because arc is having only radius. So this is the radius of this arc. So this is how the arc is drawn by using 3-point method. Now again to draw arc by using different method, click on arc, you will have the next start, center, end. So let us draw a line. Okay, so click on line and draw a line of any dimension and press escape. So this is the line. Now again go to arc option, then start, center, end. So this is the start of the line, this is the midpoint of the line, that is the center line, and this is the end point. So what we have to do, we have to select start, sorry, then center and end. If you will take the start point from here, you will get that arrow in downward direction, arc in downward direction. And if you will start from this point and end at this point, you will get the arc at the upper portion of this line. So this is how the arc is drawn by using start, center, end. Next option is start, center, angle. Okay, so for this I am taking the line only for the start or center point, otherwise we have no need to draw a line. So by using this line command, we will draw a new line, then escape, then go to arc, then start center angle. So in this case, what we have to do, we have to select start center. So we have selected this center point of the line, and then angle. At what angle we have to draw the arc? Okay. Now ortho on is mode. Ortho mode is on, so we have to off it so that we can draw the arc at any angle. So if you want to draw the arc at 170 degree, so click 170, type 170, and then press enter. So this is the arc which is drawn at 170 degree. Okay. Next is center. Oh, sorry. Start center length. Now, what I have to do? I have to do draw a line by using start center length. So in this case, what we do, start center length. So I will take the same line. Now I will start from here. We'll start center. Now length. I want to give the arc length to this arc. So let the arc length be 100. Press enter. So this is the arc of arc length 100. I have drawn by using start center length option of arc. Next option is start and angle. So for this, I am taking in line. By clicking on the line, we will get the line command. So this is moving at any angle. So ortho mode is off in that condition. You have to on this ortho mode. Now line will move in horizontal direction or in vertical direction. So line has been drawn. Escape on the line command. Now the next option of drawing arc is start and angle. So what we have to do, we have to select the start point, end point, and what we have to do, we have to provide the angle. Now the arc is only moving to 90 degree. It means ortho mode is on. So you have to off this ortho mode. Now this arc can be drawn at any angle. You have to specify that angle. So type the required angle, it will be 80, then press enter. So this is the arc which is drawn at 80 degree. Now next is start and direction. Start and direction. So for this, what we have to do, we have to pick the start and end point, and we have to give direction only. If, let us suppose this is the start point, this is the start point, this is the end point. And if we move in this direction, then the arc will draw in this direction. If we move in this direction, then the arc will draw in this direction. Okay. Like this. Now next is start and radius. You have to know the start point, end point, and you have to give the radius for this option. How? So if start point or end point is known, then select this option. If start point is this one, if end point is this one, now you have to give radius. So give radius as 200, then enter. So this is the arc drawn by using start and end radius command. Now the next option is center, start, end. Now what we have to do, we have to first of all select center, then start, and then end. Okay. So click on this option and you can see that it is center, start, end. Now the AutoCAD is specifying you that you have to select the start, the center command. Now you have to select the start point. This is the start point, and what is the end point? End point is this one. So now what will happen? The arc is drawn in this direction. We can draw like this also. Select start, center, end. The center, start, and end. So this arc is drawn like this. In the previous, we have taken this start point. Now we have taken start point in this direction. Next is center, start, angle. So if we know the center, then we know the start point, and we have to go at the angle. Let us suppose this is center, start, angle. So this is the center, start, and angle. Now you can provide the angle which you want to give. Okay, for example, we have to give 70 degrees. So press enter and you will get the arc like this by using center, start, angle. Now center, start, length. Center, start, length. Now you have to specify the length of the arc. What length of the arc is to be drawn? So you have to give the length of the arc. So this is how you will get the arc by using center, start, length. Now this is the last option, that is the continue option. If you want to draw the arc continue in a continue manner, what we have to do, we have to select, click at the point which you want to do, then you can specify the angle or direction or length, anything of the arc, and press the point at which you want to end the arc. So for example, I have end the arc here. So this is the arc which is drawn continuously. Okay, so these are the different methods of drawing arc in AutoCAD. So they are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There are 11 methods of drawing arc in AutoCAD. So today's lecture is over. Thank you so much and have a nice day.